The Industrial Revolution ushered in a new era that threatened to transform the values of men. No longer would spirituality be their compass, but not all welcomed the change. In 1783, just as the fires of the Lackey eruption had plunged all of Europe into an ashen darkness, a horde of demons spilled from the shadows and fell upon city after English city. It was a message. The Alchemy Guild, fearing the rise of industrialism and abandonment by their wealthy patrons, had done the unthinkable to defend their existence. Through recondite arts, the alchemists had created shard binders, humans transplanted with crystal that attuned them to demonic power. They sacrificed the shard binders, and in doing so, threw the gates of the world open to demonkind. Countless innocents died, and though the church succeeded in vanquishing the Hell's End, a steep price had already been paid and collected. As for the shard binders, they were presumed to have all died in the sacrificial rite. However, two survived. Jeebel, a boy for whom by some miracle the rite did not prove fatal. And Miriam, a girl who was spared the rite altogether on account of the strange slumber that took her just before it could begin. 10 years have passed, but mankind too soon forgets tragedy. The demons have returned, presaged by a great castle. And on this very hour, Miriam awakens. Upon learning Jeebel is the architect of this new, blood-stained ritual, Miriam and the alchemist Johannes set forth for the accursed castle. Their galleon cuts through the water, lancing towards the inevitable.
Certain it was...
It was Jeebel's doing, Miriam. No mistake.
It's so hard to believe. I wouldn't even be alive if not for him. He's a good soul.
I know. I know how you feel. But the facts are apparent. And the hell he endured 10 years ago would break the best of souls. Miriam, I want you to know that I'm sorry. What my brothers subjected you to, there's no forgiving it.
It was their transgression, not yours. You always took care of us.
Obviously, not enough.
Well, let it go, Johannes. We need to focus on the task ahead. If Jeebel is responsible for the summoning, then I have to stop him. I gave him my word.
I ought to do it. He was my best friend.
But I'm the only one who can. The shard experiments prepared me for combat. Let them amount to something. 10 whole years. What put me in that sleep?
I wish I had the answer. All I know is the spell that stopped time for you was advanced, arcane. But by observing the ebb of the magic's hold on you, I was able to predict exactly when you would wake up.
Oh, I see.
We'll make landfall soon. You should get ready. I had the chest there, packed with essential equipment. Now would be a good time to put it on. Good. You're prepared. The next order of business is to...
I'll take care of it.
Was that a shard?
I'd forgotten the way it felt. Like uninvited claws scraping across my bones.
The demon's power was transmuted into that shard, which forcibly bonded to the crystal embedded in your body. The strength you gain from it is undeniable, but eventually, the crystal will devour you.
I thought the procedure you discovered halted the corruption.
It did, but that doesn't guarantee you'll be safe if you start absorbing shards in massive quantities.
I know my body's limits better than anyone. And I'm going to need all the power I can get. If I run into trouble, you can help me. You've done it before. You'll do it again.
Thanks for giving me a choice in the matter. Well, I won't let you down. Not if I can help it. Just promise you won't push yourself.
How did they get inside?
The demons from the castle must have infested the ship.
Then they can help me wake up these muscles of mine. I'll wipe the deck with them. This device responds to magic. Maybe I just need to hold my hand up to it. Thank you.
Thank you.